Hello, everybody. Welcome to Forza Horizon 1. The OG, the original, the one that started it all out for everyone. And due to the service being kicked offline a few days ago by Playground 10, Turn 10 Games, I thought, why not come back to what started it all? Forza Horizon 1 was released back in the day on Xbox 360 and was the best racing game of its time, getting the highest marks for any review and any game. This was the first ever Forza game, actually, that brought in this right here. Transition from daytime into nighttime. Look at that, that's beautiful. This game is what kicked it off for a lot of car fans that loved the motorsports scene, but wanted to have that ability of free roam street racing. Forza Horizon did it all. This game was incredible to play and extremely good fun, and brought a lot of friendships closer together and made new ones as well. Look at the graphics. They don't look much different right now to what more of the modern Horizons look like. There's some downsides, but this game was just beautiful. I will never get sick of that. So, what are we doing here today? We are trying our best to give this a run. I'm hoping I'm able to start a brand new game. I did delete all my saves out of this game before because I'd already played the game. So I'm hoping maybe Forza will be nice enough to let me start over again. And if we can, our challenge is to see if we can beat this game without spending any money on buying a new car or buying upgrades for a car. Now, I will admit there's going to be some scenes in this game where I'm going to be forced to buy a brand new car, and that really sucks. But if it forces me to do it, that is out of my hands. I know fine rightly at the start of the game, you were forced to buy a car. So, aside from the forcing options, we're going to try our very best not to spend money to upgrade them or buy new cars. Now, we are allowed to accept barn find cars, we're allowed to accept pink slip cars and showcase cars. Those are the only cars we are allowed to accept, but we can't buy anything else. So, will Forza be nice enough and let me start all over again? Let's find out. If it doesn't, I will admit I will have to just quickly figure out how to reset the game. But I'm praying and hoping. Ah, the game does start me off where I was. That's not what I wanted. Dang it. Let's see if we can figure it out. No, don't save the content. God damn it, that's what I wanted to stop from happening. Bear with me a minute here, folks, while I figure this out. I think I might just have to delete the save game from the cloud that this game provides. Let me see. Oh, I can still talk as well. I don't know if you guys can even see this. That'd be kind of cool if you could. All right, Forza Horizon. Oh God, Forza Motorsport 4. Right, Forza Horizon 1. Okay, so Forza Horizon's being permanently deleted. Let's go back to the game and see what happens. Will the game accept what I've done, or will the game crash and have a complete meltdown? So far, so good. We're loading up back up again, nice and easy. Come on, game. That was weird having to go back in my 360 save games again. It's been over 10 years since I had to do that. Oh, yeah, there we go. Sweet. So, we'll upgrade it to that. We'll enable the subtitles for everyone to see. And here we go. Let's go beat this game without spending any money. I'll shut up low to let you guys enjoy this intro once again. Yeah, it is about. Oh, sorry, I was just smiling the whole way through that. But it's not over yet. We get that really nice intro, and then we get this kick-ass awesome one that the game provides us. You can sort of replay this in Forza Horizon 5, but it doesn't compare to what Horizon 1 is. And I know I'm going to copyright striped, but I don't care. YouTube, you can suck it, because this is awesome.
Hey guys, you're listening to Horizon Base Arena with me, Scott Tyler, on the first day of the Horizon Festival. It's already a beautiful Colorado morning here with a forecast for high energy, scattered rhythms, and plenty of thundering engines. Hey, the word here is that the reigning champ, Darius Flint, will be arriving at Horizon today. So, if you're on the roads just now, then stay out of his way, kids. He does not.
Here we go.
This is Horizon. Keep it here.
God, I tell you, straight out of the gate, I could feel the difference from Horizon 5 to Horizon 1. Oh, you were so being muted. Oh, Darius! Madman! Oh, the Viper just sounds so much better here. Sounds like a proper Viper. Of course, this is a Horizon that had no engine swaps, no tuning, nothing. It was just you, the upgrades, and the car.
Well, this is shaping up to be Horizon's biggest year yet. The Horizon Championship starts tomorrow morning, and I have places in the heats up for grabs to the next 10 cars who arrive at the Horizon entrance.
Oh, damn, girl, that is too cool. Hey, yo, if anyone out there is still on their way, you have got a chance to make it into the Horizon heats. Come on!
Oh, I tell you one thing, it is weird having a car with no number plate. Look at the interiors back in the day. It doesn't really look that much different, except for, you know, a couple of the dials are easier to see. Hello, Silva. I Oh, I was such a child to love this too much. No horns in this game either. That's the Xbox thing. Ooh, sorry. Back in the day, whenever you used to do drag racing in this game, it was all done by light drop. It used to be free brake lights and then shift into reverse, and that's how you send people on their way. Look at the vehicle damage as well, even, for example. Look at that. That's one messed up Volkswagen. Where's the Lambo? Oh, there's the Lambo. Come on, Stark. I mean, you had no way of ever failing this. This is what I liked about it. Goes. And we are in. That's how easy it is.
Yep, we're done. Close the gate. Congratulations, you made the heat. That's an access sticker, a map, and a pass to the qualifier events. And this is so I can get in touch if I need to. You'll need to get your car checked out by a race engineer, Dax Stewart, over at the garage. I'm Alice Hart, by the way. Welcome to Horizon.
Mr. Tack has problem with my car, I think.
Damn right. You need to swap out these fancy shocks for something a farmer would recognize, or you don't race.
Yes, Mr. Tack.
Yeah, the trouble with you kids these days is you try bending the rules before you learn the game. Hey, 95 VW Corrado. Used to own one myself. Of course, I looked after mine. Turn her over. Timing's off. On the bright side, this fine automobile shouldn't get you killed. Now that's your pass. You'll need to come back and see me for performance upgrades to stay competitive.
We can't.
If you make it through the heats, of course.
We can't spend any money, Dak. We're in such trouble.
Okay, kid. The heat you're competing in is marked on your map. Set your GPS to it. Okay. Now get over there and do your ride some justice. I forgot to say your car radio was stuck on one channel. I gave it a whack, and you can now tune to all three Horizon radio stations. Enjoy!
You like that? He says he looks after his Volkswagen Corrado, and yet he just sunk his boot inside our radio to make all them work. I keep trying to do manual with clutch. Now, I will admit, there's one thing we do have to try and...
You'll need to finish in the top three to qualify for your first wristband. Good luck!
Thank you, Alice. So there's one thing we do need to touch base on real quick, folks. That's the difficulties. Now, I'm still going to do what I normally do on Horizon 5, you know, run traction control off, stability control off, manual clutch. But I'm not going to have the AIs on the hardest setting. The reason being is I know fine rightly from previous experiences in some races, beating the AI on the hardest setting is impossible without upgrades. So to make it fair, I'm going to have it on the second highest difficulty possible. Just to make it still a challenge, but also so that I can have a chance of actually getting these done. Which I... Oh, you earn more money as a result. I can't bloody spend it, though, can I? Okay, so we have medium, hard, or pro. Pro, I think, is the most... Oh, and expert. Wait, that's not the AI, though, is it? Oh, opponent difficulty. Okay, so, yeah. We're gonna have ABS off. Simulation steering, new traction control, manual clutch, braking only, cosmetic damage on, rewinds turned off, and we'll have them on hard. Alright, that is the settings we are going to run with, and hopefully do very well. I believe this is going to have to be a part series as well though, folks, because there's no way in hell I can beat all of Horizon 1 in one shot. There's that controller drift that I'm used to now. We'll leave the music on though. I mean, YouTube's gonna copyright strike the hell out of me when I upload this, but I actually just don't care. Out of the way, Gilbert. The reason why I don't care is you can't play Horizon without the music on. So for anyone that's not able to watch this on my YouTube channel when it eventually popped over there, I'm sorry, but I really just don't care. I wanted to come back to this game due to the servers getting shut down, and it offers myself a little challenge. What I will do, though, real quick, because I'm noticing the car is louder than the music, so let's just turn the car down slightly so that we can enjoy the music a little bit more. Oh! You can shut up too.
Fucking GPS at 400 yards, turn in me.
I feel like the car is a little bit too loud, but we'll find out. You're probably thinking, oh, well, Ash, AIs are way too far behind you now. Don't worry, races get harder. Trust me. There's also something else I need to touch base on here real quick, because you're about to find out. The servers might be down, but the speed campers and speed zones... Wait, no, hang on. This is Horizon 1, so there's only... Thank you. Oh, Red Rock. God, there's a journey and a half. So the speed cameras, because I forget, this is Horizon 1, so drift zones and speed zones weren't invented. I got banned. Not my fault. I keep freaking stalling the car. There we go. I got banned because I got gifted traffic cars, playground copy of them, so they stripped me from ever competing in these again. No, there is speed zones. Sorry, apologies. I'll say that new PB all the time, but I can't feed them. Mm-hmm. salvage the outposts. Can I discover that actually while I drive by? Oh, the media center. God. So this actually, while I'm here, this was the main drag strip back in the day. So used to land a car that was up here and used to do side by side, but the flag car had the job of sitting here. And it used to be 1, 2, 3, breathe. And as soon as you saw them reverse lights, you were just gone. You had to race all the way down until you actually got past the motorway here. It's above us. That was one of Dax's discount signs. Smash them to get discounts on your upgrades to Dax's garage and the festival. Rising pulse to keep you driving. And you used to finish pretty much when you passed here. This was the finish line. That's pretty much where that Chrysler PT was. We used to brake and turn around here and then race back if they wanted to. I remember this off by heart. Red Rock, this road here, you started from the junction back there and you drifted your ass all the way up. And you drifted all the way back down. It used to be where some drivers used to recruit new drivers to be in their clubs back in the day for drifting. You had your standard drifters that would be here and then the speed drifters would be here too. Because you actually could speed drift Red Rock quite easily. Look at these. That is the perfect title, Mustang versus Mustang. Playground and Turn 10, they had this dialed down perfectly back in the day. I'm sorry. Yeah. Close but fun. God, even the Mustang sounds better. Look at how low he goes. So when I was on about the drifting, this is the turnaround point right here, and you drift this entire road all the way down. This car just sounds amazing. Bit of a drift. Go on. I could say drifting back in this game was easier or harder. I'd actually say it would be easier back here. It didn't feel like it, so we couldn't tune the cars. I mean, you got modders that used to bring in modded cars, and you could do it that way. I mean, I had a rear wheel drive Evo 10 back in the day, and I used to drift that round a different drift zone. God damn, I love that. So much better. There's none of this flappy paddle gearbox crap. It was, if the car had a manual, it had a manual, and you saw every transaction. Or transition, sorry. Transaction, goddammit, that's not the right term, but yeah. Alright, got too distracted there. Oh boy. Yep. Oh, here comes everyone's favorite turn. I can't drift. I can't drift it that well. Yeah, we can.
You just bagged a sweet new ride, and now you know why showcase events are invite only. Everyone wants to get their hands on one of those.
Yeah, I'll drive the Mustang. God, there's Finley Dam. I'm amazed. I will still remember a lot of places. Alright, let's GPS that and go back.
I organize showcase events like that Mustang race for the fans, and I try to book the most popular drivers. If you want to get invited, increase your popularity at the festival by showing off your skills as you drive. Maybe if you get more popular, I'll give you a call.
Maybe I will, maybe I won't. Can't tell if the car's at a good enough audio with the music, so if anyone's watching the stream right now, if you can let me know if the car isn't overpowering the music. So I'm curious to know. Oh, they have to lose a skill chain. Look at that sunset. I mean, if you ignore the blurry lights because it's their first time ever doing this, they had Colorado perfectly seen. Nothing could beat this. Not for back in 2012. This was just the best thing ever. It was free roam, nighttime set in pretty quickly. Oh Lord. I wonder who Marco is. It was the guy with the Mercedes and the bowler hat. Yes, Mr. Duck. Some of the people that was in this game, the ones that were your main competitors throughout the wristbands. Were pretty awesome. I mean, there was maybe one or two people within this game that, oh, I'm gonna lose it. Nope, I'm good. That was close. No, there was a couple of drivers back in this game that I didn't like. Playground did them justice and gave them like a real arrogant, cocky, I'm better than you type of thing. Oh. Oh boy. Look at how we paint shop, the online marketplace, the car club, the central where you went and you actually did everything, which is where I need to stop at. Then you have the auto show here. And then Dax Garrett's at the other end. Not everything was under one roof. It was... I can't tell you how perfect this setup was. It wasn't this, oh, we're just completely lazy and we'll make everything possible under one roof. You had to go elsewhere.
Okay, I get it. No dangerous ass clown behavior. I swear.
Oh, hi. You're the new guy. Here, nice driving. You bagged the last slot. That wristband means you made the championship. There are 249 other drivers competing this year, and believe me, every one of them is more famous around here than you. Darius, hold on a minute, will you? If you want to make a name for yourself at Horizon, it's all about how you drive. The crowds come to see spectacular racing, and I can always use a driver who has the crowd on his side. Darius, what's wrong now?
And this is what I was talking about. This is the only time I believe Forza forces you to buy a car. So aside from this one-off transaction here between the game and me, this'll be it. And due to I'm an evil fan, I'll always go evil. I'm sorry. We'll have it in gray. Have it in like a gunmetal-ish gray kind of color. That makes Mike happy. I know he loves gunmetal gray. But yeah, this will definitely be a series of Horizon 1, folks. I'll be looking forward to this. I'm probably trying to do multiple a day. There's no fast... No, there was a fast travel feature, I think, but... Eh, we're not gonna... Let's hit fast travel anywhere. Okay, we can't do that yet. So, we do. We have to drive there. That's fine. Thankfully, at least I was one of the fortunate people back in the day that did buy everything for this game. I bought the 1000 car pack, I bought the Horizon Rally expansion. So, if we can beat this game, we'll dip our toes into the rally side of it. Show you guys what the original rally expansion pack looked like. For those that maybe hate Horizon 5s. Because trust me, when you play Horizon 1s, you will actually come to realize that Horizon 5 did improve quite a lot. I do love that this game came with its own sponsorships. It just feels so weird. In all fairness, it does feel weird, but it feels perfectly fine. Going back 10 years in the Horizon series, it just feels normal to me. Ah, yes, Miss Ford Raptor. I remember her. Here we go. Is she gonna insult me or is she gonna be quite nice about it? No, that's an insult. Okay. Horrible line. Come here, Adams. I need a draft off your Mercedes. No, please don't leave me. I need your car. Oh god, hello. Don't need it that much. Actually, it's not the Evo's fault, I've just remembered. My controller doesn't like turning at times. Oh boy. Didn't need to do that. Oh, pushing me! Stop ramming me! She is all over my ass. I can't catch Daro. Gonna have to restart the race. The Range Rover just... Yep. Okay. I don't accept second place. I'm sorry. But I'm gonna win this one. This is the one race that is difficult to do at the very beginning of the game anyway. You're put against such cars that have the ability to just go, yeah, we're gonna leave you right behind. Slow down, no, sorry, car. Whoever kept the 2CV behind me. Much better run this time. Your Ford Raptor, you're used to it. That's payback for last race, Kravash. He's gonna hit the damn brakes, isn't he?
Yep.
There you go. Come here. So resisting Daro. There we go. Second time's a charm. He's not gonna catch me again. We're fine. Sorry, you will catch me sing along to a couple of these songs now and again. Gotta remember, this game and the songs are installed into my head free of charge. There we go. Got it the second time. Just could not, for some reason, catch the Range Rover in that first attempt. Lovely. Should have a couple of more races for us to do, I hope.
Two more yellow events. It's up to you which order you enter them in.
Well, we'll do the sprint race, and then we'll do the circuit race. Because I know the circuit race requires us to use the SIBO again. If I want to get money, but unfortunately I can't spend it, Miss Alice. I've restricted myself.
Stop giving me this.
Alright, just need a blast for a speed camera. Couldn't resist. United States car only. Yeah, but we have one already, Miss Harper. No, what was her name? Oh, it was Harp. Sorry, not Harper, it's Harp. I don't know. I'll just call her Miss Flatass. No, I can't. I can't. There we go again. Oh, you're funny. Yeah, I love how everyone in front of me is American, except for... I know that Ford's made in America, so I guess the ST is allowed, but that just seems weird. Oh, that's how to go from near the back of the pack to near the front. Oh! God damn it, don't do that to me. Lamb, notice I'm here, thank you. Roach as well, this is the fun part. I'll listen to you at the minute, Kravash. Yep. Ha-ha! Cheers, my dear. I'll take another win. Did you now? Kind of ironic, we need 20 points and yet we're going to get 100 in the next race. No, we need to stay inside the Evil, unfortunately, because it's the next car. We need to hop inside. F40. Gladstone Drive. Do our next race. So, just makes sense in my mind to take the second one.
You're getting noticed. You're getting it up, and you can get a slot in the green wristband event.
You can get a slot in the green wristband event. I will, come on. Just how much further can I push this, to be fair? How am I gonna beat the end bit? I've just really figured this out. This might be a bit impossible. Because to beat the end, you have to do a qualifier against some really high-end competitive cars. I don't think I get high-end cars rewarded to me. That wasn't so much of an insult towards me, so I'll give you that. My son. Well, Darrow finally got rid of his useless Range Rover and got an Evo. Still want to use them though to get around the corners. That's a barkeeper. Keep her there. Please. That Raptor gets past that Evo, I'm screwed. No, my controller drift. It just decided to screw me there. I might be able to get it back though, because I know I'm faster here. I'm sorry, car. Brakes hard. Oh, got it. We got it. Yeah, we definitely got it. She doesn't have the speed on the Evo. Wah! Oh, I love how my controller, right at the worst possible turn, decided we're not going to give you full left lock. That was evil. Moving on up. Moving on up. Gotcha.
You got the wristband, but you won't beat me one on one. I'll stake. Come find me if you're man
enough. Oh, will you? If I'm man enough. All right. Okay. Second here. Streamers, we just go happily put her in her. That's an exige. Happily put her in her place is what I was trying to say. Do you know what? This is going to be a stupid idea. I should race her in the Evo, but I'm going to challenge her in the Garado. Do you want to know why? I don't care. Let me race anyway. I want to know if I can beat her with a stock Garado. Okay? If I can, because I'm not man enough, alright? We'll beat you with a lower grade car. See how cocky you are now. Oh, nobody come back? Shame. Change off that rock station though. We're gonna go to Space Arena. Yeah, your 4-ton Raptor ain't really going anywhere, is it? Bye! See, folks, arrogance is the worst thing ever. Shortcut! Hey, I'm like driving a front wheel drive to know you're alive. Ooh, she is. Oh, she means business. She is coming back like a thundercloud. Oh boy, she is really coming back. Holy crap. Beetle. Rattle for speed might not have been a good idea. Come on, little Volkswagen. I know you can do it. That's not good, 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 that's not good. Get out the way, get out the way, get out the way. Do not turn left. Thank you. Oh boy. I'm actually happy I beat her with an old school. Oh. No insults? Two compliments? You feeling okay? Blue Monday, new order.
Hey, what's up? Your race band is still waiting.
Yes, I knew I was right. Did you hear that?
Just select the outpost you want from your map, you pay the fee, and then we do all the hard work to make sure you're placed just outside it.
Oh yeah, that's a fast travel ability. But I can't use it because it requires money. I'm sorry, the Raptor's just... Oh, this is overthrowing the music easily. God damn! Oh boy. We'll drive at a lower RPM to try and let you guys be able to hear the music as well. Oh boy. I think what I'll do, now that I remember everything, I will do a wristband per episode.
If you're out there, qualification for the green wristband events just ended. Some hungry new talent joining you at this level, Ali, so watch out.
And that's our next rival, by the way, in case you didn't give it away there, Scott. Yeah, we'll do a wristband per episode. A lot of races and stuff that we could do in between, so we'll keep this to at least a minimum of a wristband per episode. So we'll go over, we'll collect our green wristband, because we're not going to include the first one that we got, the yellow, because that was easy enough to do. It was like a single race and we were there. So at least the green one was a legit one. So we'll collect this. And this is where our first restriction really comes into play. We cannot do this one because we don't have a JDM car. That's a D-class anyway. So, what we might end up having to do is... I don't know. I don't even know if we can do this, to be honest with you. But we will have to give it a try. And see if we can get it in the next episode, folks. But as of so far, that is it for Forza Horizon 1 Episode 1, guys. And gals as well, for anyone that watches. So, join me next time, where we will continue our escapade of trying to beat this game without spending any money. I'm worried to know if we can do this, or if we can't do this. Find out in the next episode, everyone. Until then, enjoy the rest of your day or week, and I will catch you all within the next stream. Thank you and goodbye.